Okay, thank you everybody who's for I was gonna say coming out, but for staying home. Hope the weather's okay. I'm Tom, I play the cello, and this is Kinan, he also plays the cello. That's all we're gonna do tonight, and we're gonna be joined, as you know if you're here, by a special guest in for the second half of the program. This is really a great opportunity for us. We get to, this is a chance for us to improvise and to you know, play some pieces that we've each written and some other things. So again, it's really nice to assume that you're all out there listening. We're gonna, some of you might have noticed that our cellos are tuned a little differently for this. Normally, the lowest string on the cello would be this, but I brought it down to a B flat, and Kinan also. This retuning, this what we call scordatura, this is my fault, because I wrote a couple of pieces for two cellos with these detuned cellos. I kind of like the idea of them being the same instrument but different instruments. So this is the first of these pieces. We played it, I don't know, it wasn't a year ago. When was that?
Maybe
7 months. I remember it was kind of cold.
Yeah.
So. And we played it outside. This is called Slapdash.
Thank you.
Okay, and then I'll pretend everybody's applauding. The next piece is also something I wrote for the same combination of strangely tuned cellos. I thought of it as sort of a contrasting piece, but when I wrote it, I forgot all the violent contrasts that already happened in the first piece. So, but you can still hear it as something different. I called this one Shelter. I was trying to come up with the title, and I was just thinking Shelter in Place. You know, it feels like a little what we were all doing. So this is Shelter.
Thank you.
We're going to finish out the first half of our show with another improvisation. And then we're going to take, I think, a six-minute break so we can retune our cellos and bring Shinjoo out here. And I know everybody's been just going to the bathroom whenever they want to anyway, so we don't have to allow time for that. But stick around for the second half. After this, there's going to be a piece by Kinan. Of course, you're going to hear some bandoneon and some solos from some of us. So, anyway.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Stick around for a little bit. We'll be back with Shinjoo Cho.
In the news, they do.
welcome to Shinjoo Cho, fantastic bandoneon player and our good friend. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I like that this is not going anywhere I thought.
Well, I won't ask what you thought because you know, we're in public. Great, so the next piece is going to be you two, right?
Yes. It's always good to sort of open up the years before we play anything specific and planned and written. And today we're going to play, this piece is was actually written for violin and cello. And we have adapted it to bandoneon and cello. And Kinan and I have had the pleasure of playing this, I think sometime in November. It was very cold when the world order was different. And this piece is composed by Ramiro Gallo, an Argentine composer, violinist, and a tango musician and educator. And it's the rhythm is based on a slow milonga, which is in the sort of habanero rhythm, bam, ba, bam, bam. And within tango, there's a few rhythms, main tango rhythms, and this is one of them, which relates a little bit more to a folk style. When it's played at this sort of walking tempo, it's called milonga campera. And based on that mood and that rhythm, the piece is actually titled Casas Bajas. And we're going to see how it comes out.
Thank you.
All right, now I'm going to play a short cello solo by one of my favorite composers, one of my favorite musicians. Her name is Nansi Carroll. She might be listening, in which case, hi, Nancy. Her name is spelled N-A-N-S-I, and then Carroll with two R's and two L's. Since you don't, well, maybe, actually, it's probably in your program information, in the, it's probably on the description of this event. This is my quartet. I play in a string quartet called the Daedalus Quartet, and we had the pleasure last year, before all this happened, of premiering a new work by Nansi with the incredible soprano Karen Slack. Nansi had set, I want to say five spirituals for soprano and string quartet. We played this at UPenn, and we're looking forward to playing them again when it becomes possible to do that. But this is a piece that Nansi wrote about a little more than 10 years ago, and it's another spiritual. This one is based on the spiritual, Gonna Tell God All My Troubles. It's for solo cello. The way Nansi describes it, it starts out as a work song with a very heavy beat and then goes through some increasingly abstract variations, and then we wind up with a final sort of lonely, mournful statement of the tune.
Thank you. Beautiful.
He's from Shinjoo.
We'll go from strings to buttons and lots of air. I'm going to play a piece, a traditional tango piece by Francisco de Caro called Flores Negras. And this tune is a well-loved tango tune. And the version I will be playing is arranged by Astor Piazzolla, the Argentine composer and bandoneonist, who's responsible for much of the world really paying attention and falling in love with tango and music that's coming out of Argentina still. Do you want to say anything about your piece? This is
This is the chance. Well, the next piece is it's titled "Let Them In," and it was written in a time that there were some people waiting outside some borders, and some they didn't let them in, and I mean there is no need to mention which two countries and which border, but I think this is happening so much everywhere, like in the Middle East and outside in Europe. So it's just the piece is technically for people who need to come in, and hopefully they let them in. One more, I'm sorry, yeah. There is a very rhythmic pattern, especially in the second half of the piece, that keeps repeating. And as we say in Arabic music, we call it hishtik bishtik, which is very like the very common, like simple people rhythm. So it was mentioned or quoted here, like that specific rhythm, just like for the personality of the people, that they're always, like whatever happens to them, there's always some pleasure and happiness.
Thank you.
close the program with a tribute to Ennio Morricone, who wrote so many great, well, I think not just film scores, he wrote a lot of music, there's chamber music and all sorts of stuff, but we're gonna play some film scores. I don't know if there's anything more that needs to be said. He died very recently. His music is in everybody's ear, and so we're gonna try to bring it to you tonight. Thank you so much for tuning in, and it's been thanks to everybody here at Turtle Studios, to Jay Levin and Doug and Sean, who I didn't get their last names, and Rocco and all the people at with the doing the camera work. It's really great to have this opportunity to play what really feels like a concert. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. It's been a joy to do this, and thank you for being here.
That was my first.
I am so sorry.